In this video, the ultimate goal is to compute the density of the moon based on some simple astronomical data from Wikipedia, and we're going to pay close attention to using the correct number of significant digits in our calculation. So we're given the radius of the moon as 1,737.4 kilometers. We're given the mass of the moon as 7.342 times 10 to the 22 kilograms. And in part A, we're computing the volume of the moon in cubic meters. And this means we immediately need to get that radius number into meters instead of kilometers. So I look at that radius and I think, well, that's 1.7374 times 10 to the third kilometers. If I then multiply that by 1,000 to get meters, it's just a 10 to the sixth instead. Then I apply the formula for the volume of a sphere. That's 4/3 pi r cubed. And I'm keeping plenty of extra precision just for the moment. So I get 2.19679 times 10 to the 19th cubic meters. Then I need to think about, well, where should this be rounded? And the input into this calculation was this radius that was written down to 5 significant digits. So I'm going to round off to 5 significant digits. And that means I round up to an 8 in that last decimal place. So I get 2.1968 times 10 to the 19th cubic meters. In part B, we're asked to go ahead and get the density of the moon. And density is the mass divided by the volume, measured in kilograms per cubic meter. We were given the mass to 4 significant digits. And again, I'll just go ahead and state a bunch of extra precision just so I can illustrate how the rounding works. When I look at the numbers that went into this calculation, the mass was rounded to 4 significant digits originally. And our volume was kept to 5 significant digits. That means we're going to round our final answer to 4 significant digits. So our 3,342.15 kilograms per cubic meter becomes simply 3,342 kilograms per cubic meter. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left. Or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.